simple. But God loves everybody. Loves you, loves me. People like you might think don't deserve to be loved. God loves. But God has made each one of us in his own image and according to his own likeness. And he loves us because we are his creation. God is love, the Bible says. And that God does love us. And he's demonstrated his love through his son, the Lord Jesus Christ, when he died upon the cross at Calvary. When he took upon himself all our guilt, all our shame, all our griefs, all our sorrows. Jesus bore them in his body upon the cross of Calvary. That's how much God loves each and every one of us. He has demonstrated it through the Son on the cross. That's how he showed us he loved us. He has loved us enough to sacrifice his own Son for sinners like me, for sinners like you. Isn't that good news? That's good news. So what does God's love look like? Well, God's love, it's an unconditional love. He loves us despite what we think, what we do, what we say, what we don't do, what we don't say. He loves us. It's unconditional. God's love is eternal. It's an everlasting love. It will never come to an end. The love of God will never end because God is love. His love doesn't depend upon our love for him. We don't need to love God in order for him to love us. He loves us already. He loves you already. He knows you. And he loves you just as you are. As you walk past here today, know that God loves you. Just the way you are. But he wants to change you. He wants to bring about a change that only he can bring about. It's a change of heart, a change of attitude, a change of direction. Only God can do that in the life of a human being. So I want to share some words from the Bible. Speak about the love of God. John 3:16 is the most popular portion of scripture which speaks about the love of God. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. In another gospel called 1 John's Gospel, we can read that it says, in this is love. In this the love of God was manifested towards us. That means made known. The love of God was made known towards us. That God has sent his Son into the world that we might live through him. 1 John 4:16 says, and we have known and believe the love that God has for us, for God is love. And he who abides in love abides in God, and God in him. Romans chapter 5, verse 8. But God demonstrates his own love towards us, in that whilst we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Did you hear that? Whilst we were still sinners, going our own way, doing our own thing, not having a single care or thought for God, God sent his Son Jesus, who died in our place. God loves, because God is love. He loves you. He loves you, but he commands you to repent. In 1 John 4:10 it says, in this is love. Not that we love God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as a propitiation, an offering for our sins. I hope you understood today that the God who made us, He is love. That's His nature. That's His essence. He's all about love. And His love has been demonstrated through the giving of His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who came into the world to save sinners. Do you know that you're a sinner as you walk past today? Do you know that your sin has put you off from the living God? But you know that the good news is that Jesus came into the world to take away the sin of the world. But He is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Do you realize that sin, your sin, is the barrier between you and your relationship with the holy, righteous God who created you? If you understand that, and you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, you today can be forgiven of all your sin. You can be cleansed and washed clean by the precious shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I urge you today, if you have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, if you believe in His name, I urge you to cry out to Him today and ask Him to have mercy upon you. Call out and say, Lord, I'm a sinner. Have mercy. Have mercy upon me. I am a sinner. I've sinned against heaven. I've sinned against people.